I am Dr. Neema Bisht, BDS by degree and a pharma professional. Also, I am founder of Career in Pharma, wherein I provide guidance and training to healthcare professionals. I am on a mission to help 1 lakh healthcare professionals to attain financial security through career into clinical research industry. Hello everyone. Once again, I welcome you all to Career in Pharma. So today in this video, I will be discussing about the interview process and interview questions for medical reviewer or drug safety physician role or principal investigator, which is a role at a very fresher level for MBBS MD candidates, okay, and medical monitor also in some companies, depending on their job description. So if you are MBBS or MD or without MD, and if you are looking for pharmaceutical industry for clinical research and pharmacovigilance domain, then whatever I'm going to tell you in this video going to benefit a lot. So I'm going to tell you the steps of interview step process and little bit about the questions. Before that, I was just going through some comments in my videos, and I saw that few people are like asking about courses also. So let me tell you one thing, that you need to upskill yourself. You need to upskill yourself for any new field, be it your old field also. If you want to grow in any field, you need to upskill yourself on a regular basis. So this upskilling can be done free of cost, means online free. So study material is available, you can Google the information, everything is available online. Or you can take professional courses, which helps you a lot, okay? But keep this thing in mind that you need to upskill yourself. Now, what happens, you know, if there is something called free, although in this world there is nothing called free, right? There is a cost for each and everything. Not always in terms of money. The cost is not always in terms of money. You have to invest your time, energy also. So in short, there is a price tag for each and everything. Considering that, you have to upskill yourself for free of cost, or you can take professional help. Now what happens whenever you take any professional help? By taking any professional help, first you get into that zone of how you can, you know, work upon the things, how you can look for jobs, how you can prepare for interviews, important interview questions, like many things happens if you come into that zone. But if you are doing something not necessarily free, but if you are not a part of community for that matter, then it becomes little bit challenging if you are not enough self-motivated person. But if you are someone who is, you know, self-motivated enough, very, you know, self-inspiring kind of person, then you can go alone also. For you, not necessary you should be a part of community. You can go alone, you can, you know, search out the information, material, everything online, Google, everywhere information is available through LinkedIn also. But keep this in mind, upskilling is very much required at a fresher level also and during your career growth also. Now with this, I will come to the main video. The topic of today's video is the interview step process for medical reviewer, drug safety physician or principal investigator. Now, first step, we call it as the screening phase, and this screening can happen online. Online means you will get a mail in which there is a task will be assigned to you, and in that task nothing will be there. You just have to mention your degree, your year of finishing graduation or any experience you have, just basic information you have to give. That is kind of a screening. Or if it's not online screening, you will get a call from HR. Okay, HR will also asking you the same question. They will noting down all your answers. Or in few companies, I mean very less, it's like 2-3 companies among 100 who may take your aptitude as well. Now in aptitude, there will be like basic grammar, biochemistry, biology questions, so little bit of, you know, little bit like LCM, HCF, those kind of mathematics question, blood relation question. It's all like aptitude, very basic one they will check. So through these they will screen, means once they are satisfied with your aptitude or your basic information, or you are the candidate what they are looking for, then you are into next round, that is technical round. Now technical round will happen with any doctor definitely, because being you also a doctor and MBBS, that will happen with any doctor only, and that is like technical. And in that round, technical round, they will be asking you about basic about the subject. Subject means about pharmacovigilance. If you are going to give interview for drug safety physician or medical reviewer, in that case you should be knowing basic about pharmacovigilance, like what is pharmacovigilance, definition, and little bit about PVPI programs, you know, history of pharmacovigilance, how it started, maybe 1-3 main famous event inside pharmacovigilance, or maybe the recent one which happened in, you know, Uzbekistan. There many kids died because of the cough syrup. Okay, that news maybe you must be knowing. They may ask you about what is case processing, what is MedDRA, what is WHODD. They may ask you about what are the, you know, identifiers for any case to be valid, like basic questions about pharmacovigilance at a very fresher level, whatever is required, they will ask you. Or if you are going to give interview for any clinical research profile like medical monitor or principal investigator, in that case they will ask you about basics of clinical research phases, what happens in different kind of phases, ethics committee, informed consent process. I mean, just basic they will ask about clinical research if you are going to give for clinical research profile. So this is about the basic question about pharmacovigilance in clinical research. Apart from this, you will also get questions from your clinical background. Let's say you are MD in diabetology, you are diploma in some diabetology, then in that case for you questions will be from diabetes. Sometimes what happens, always do your own R&D and, you know, Google everything about the company you are going to give interview. For example, if you have to give interview for Novo Nordisk, which is a pharmaceutical company, so just Google about Novo Nordisk, what the company does, what is their core area, what are their, you know, drugs, Novo Nordisk drugs, what actually is the area they deal with. Accordingly, you prepare clinical questions also. So suppose if you are going to give interview in any company who is regularly conducts clinical trial for any cancer patients, or they are masters in chemotherapeutic agent, then in that case you should be knowing about chemotherapeutic agent, classification, mode of action, and a little bit about disease part also. Okay, so these are like very basics of clinical question. Other than this, your core area, your core strength, and about the company which you are going to give interview, about those, that company also you just Google in relation to your clinical question, and also Google what actually the company do, little bit Google the information, little bit R&D about the company also required. Okay, now this is about your technical round, like your clinical questions also they will ask, and little basics about pharmacovigilance clinical research, considering for which profile you are going to give interview. If it's for drug safety physician, medical reviewer, not necessary they will ask you about clinical research. If it's for clinical research profile, not necessary they will ask you for pharmacovigilance, but just be prepared with basics of both, and clinical of course. Now once you are done with technical round, your interview is fine, good, everything is fine, then you will be called for the third round, that is final HR round. Now in final HR round, they will discuss about your CTC. They will ask your expectations also. Definitely whatever you are getting currently, in that you can add like up to 10-20% of addition you can do, and accordingly you can set your expectation of CTC also. But my suggestion would be, if you are seriously looking for the job, then little bit you can be flexible, don't be rigid on the CTC part. At least what you are getting currently, that also you are getting inside this job in hand salary, then it's fine, you can continue. Otherwise you can set your expectations also, but be flexible in that too. And HR will tell you about the working hours, the working location, everything. So accordingly they will check how much flexible you are, because if you are someone who is very rigid about CTC, that I will work, if I will just, you know, if I will get more than 12 lakh then only I will work, then in that case maybe you are not shortlisted in this final round, because maybe some other person is already ready for 11 lakh of CTC. So that's why I said you should be flexible in that part. Definitely there should be some, you know, end to what you are expecting. I mean, end, upper end and lower end, that beyond that you can't go, because whatever you are getting currently, exactly that at least you should get, right? So this is about the final HR. So I hope I covered all the areas, like screening round, screening like general question or maybe aptitude, second is technical round with doctors, about your clinical roles and about basics of pharmacovigilance and clinical research, and final is the final HR call on CTC and offer letter, everything they will discuss in that. Now there are two very important questions which are like a part of each and every interview, and they may, and these questions can be asked you by HR also, maybe technical head or that doctor also. So these questions are like, to start with, first of all, your basic introduction. So the person interviewer will tell you to introduce yourself. It is like a brief introduction, so don't go into deeper. Like, your brief introduction, short introduction should not go more than a minute. Within a minute you have to finish it. Just your name, your year of finishing graduation, after that whatever experience you have and what you do currently. That's all. It is your brief introduction. Second question, which is very important, and you should prepare this, what I would suggest you should prepare this, is why you want to come to non-clinical sector. That is the most important question and common question which can be asked from any healthcare profession, not just for MBBS, MD, for BAMS, for dentist, for physiotherapist, for nursing graduates. It's a very common question. So just be prepared with your answers for this, because every time they will ask you, and all you can go through my old videos also, where I have made video on this also, like why you're looking for non-clinical options. Answer for that, yeah. So I hope I was able to clear your doubts on the interview questions for medical reviewer, drug safety physician. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and please share this video with your friends also who are also looking for job inside pharmaceutical industry. With this, I'm going to conclude this video, and please comment in the comment section if you like any video, next video for me to make. Definitely I will come soon with some next video as per the suggestion, or you know, whatever comes to my mind. And till the time I come again, till that time, stay safe, healthy, aware and updated. Thank you.